What is up guys? कैसे हो आप लोग? Welcome to another video on the 23 Rides channel and today we will be talking about the Triumph T4. This is a motorcycle that is based on the Triumph Speed 400 that was launched in the India market last year, and this year Triumph has bought a different variant of that 400cc entry level motorcycle. I have the Triumph T4 right in front of me. Have a look. So this is the white color on the Triumph T4. As you can see, the graphics of the Triumph are very cool. They have a fresh new look on the tank, and this panel also says the Speed T4. A lot of visual changes on this motorcycle that we'll talk about, and I think we'll start off with the first change that you will see on this machine, which was the highlight of the Speed 400, and it's missing here, is the golden colored forks. Here you have these silver and black forks, which are a little, I would say, less attractive compared to the Speed 400. But yeah, this is what you get. And along with it, these forks are telescopic forks rather than the upside down suspension on the Speed 400. Next up, let's talk about the tires. This is also one area where Triumph has cut a little bit of cost. Obviously, that 23,000 rupee difference in price has to come from somewhere. On this T4, the tires that you get are MRF tires, Zapper tires to be very specific, and these are non-radial tires. On the Speed 400, both at the front and the back, you used to get radial tires, and the rear tire was also a little bit thicker, 150 section. This is 140 section rear tire. The next change on the T4 will be this black handlebar that you see. This is a handlebar that's made of steel rather than aluminium. Along with that, gone are those bar end mirrors that you would get on the Speed 400. Here you have these traditional rear view mirrors. From a tech standpoint, there is no ride-by-wire throttle. So you have the conventional, you know, mechanical throttle here. And along with that, you do not have traction control on this motorcycle. Apart from these cosmetic changes that I just talked about, the biggest difference is the way the engine is tuned on the T4. The Speed 400 had 40 bhp of power, 37.5 newton meters of torque, while this T4 has just 31 bhp of power and 36 newton meters of torque. So that is a figure that is going to play a lot on the minds of prospective buyers who are actually wanting to invest in the Triumph brand or get an entry into the Triumph brand and are thinking to start off with the cheapest, the most value for money Triumph, whether to go for the Speed 400 or the T4, because 9 bhp less is going to sound a lot less attractive. So in this video, I will ride this motorcycle and we will go on the expressway. We'll go and try and ride it hard and see whether that 9 bhp difference in the top end, is it something that really makes the motorcycle feel very lazy, or is it something that's more of a spec sort of a thing and does not make a lot of difference from a real life riding scenario. So let's get on the motorcycle and get riding. So Triumph has placed a condition here. They have said that before we give you the T4, you have to ride the Speed 400, because that will help you understand and appreciate the difference in both the motorcycles. The T4 is kind of a stripped down version of the Speed 400. The Speed 400 is 40 bhp, T4 is around 30 bhp. So 10 bhp of difference should be very easily apparent. So here we are on the toll bridge, the D&D flyway, and this is where we'll get an idea of the punch that this 40 bhp machine offers. Of course, that 10 bhp difference is going to be felt. They are just trying to make it a little more apparent so that we can give an accurate feedback about the relatively laid back character of the T4. Goes to 100 very easily. A smooth motorcycle. I just wanted to open the throttle because the way this motorcycle reaches 100 is going to give me a great benchmark in terms of how the T4 reaches 100 on similar roads. Let's go again. Fourth gear pickup. horn is a joke on this machine. Definitely needs an upgrade. Let's see what the T4 has to offer. So here we are back to the showroom, and now we'll get a chance to ride the T4. Let's see how that goes. So since we are on the expressway, it's a great opportunity to give you a real-time 0-100 test on the Triumph T4. 30 bhp, let's see what these 30 bhp mean in a real life acceleration scenario. Let's go. We have crossed 100 in a jiffy, and let's see how fast this goes. Where does it max out? The throttle is completely open, and we have hit 138, 39, 140 is where it's maxing out. The 140 is a speedo indicated speed, and in practical scenarios this will be something in the range of around 130, 32 kilometers per hour. So it's very close to what Triumph had promised in terms of top speed. Does the bike feel stable on the highways? Yes. Do I feel vibes while maintaining this 115 odd kilometers per hour speed? A little bit of vibes on the footpegs, very minor vibes. I mean, I will not actually call these vibes. Little bit of vibes on the handlebar as well. Nothing to be worried about. Nothing that's gonna leave your hands and feet numb after a long ride. If you are used to riding a Royal Enfield motorcycle, then this is ultra smooth compared to that. If that helps you put things in perspective. Is this motorcycle slow? I don't think so. I would actually call a motorcycle slow if it starts making different types of mechanical clatter or noises when it touches 100 plus kilometers per hour speeds. This one is very comfortable at 110 kmph. Very easy to ride and a pleasant riding experience on this beautiful stretch of road. Wow, we are maintaining 120 kilometers per hour on the expressway. It's 118 or 120, whatever you want to call it, but you get the drift, right? This is a motorcycle that can cruise at these sort of speeds. So if you want to talk about cruising on the highways, anything that can sit at 110 all day long, 100 110, is a quick motorcycle, at least in my definition, because Indian highways do not allow cruising speeds, you know, more than 110 or 120. I don't think anyone can maintain anything above 120 kilometers per hour for an extended period of time. I'm talking about 10 minutes, 15 minutes, leave alone the idea of, you know, maintaining those high speeds all day long. People try and reach 160, 170, but that happens for like 5 seconds, 6 seconds, 10 seconds. That's what I feel, until unless you are someone who rides a sports, super sports motorcycle and are just crazy enough to ride at those speeds for extended periods of time. I'm talking about a rider who wants to be a little safe on the road. For that type of a rider, this is not a slow motorcycle. I am pleasantly surprised with what 30 bhp translates to on the Triumph T4 on an open stretch of road. How does 100 feel for an extended period of time? Let's see. We are at 100. This can be done all day long. Trust me, guys, 120 felt just a little bit of a push, little bit. It's not something that you will struggle maintaining, but 100-110 is creamy smooth. So before getting a chance to ride this Triumph T4, I was thinking, why the hell did Triumph make such a motorcycle, just shaving off 23,000 rupees of the ex-showroom price? Is it such bigger deal? I totally respect 23,000 rupees might be a lot of money for a lot of people, but I was not very convinced with the idea of, you know, a motorcycle coming at a price point which was just 23,000 rupees less and missing so much of the equipment and power. Like I told you about 10 bhp less on this motorcycle and all the stuff that's missing compared to the Speed 400. But now, after riding this machine, what I feel is that this machine will definitely have its takers in the Indian market, because that is primarily where this machine will be sold. I don't think Triumph has plans of selling this machine outside of India anytime soon. For the performance that this machine offers, like you saw while I was riding, anything that's at this price point, 2.17 lakhs ex showroom, and doing 120 easily, mind you, offering you entry into the Triumph brand segment along with the top quality fit and finish that Triumph is known for, I think this seems like a great value for money proposition. Now, if you think that you really need all the tech and all the additional bells and whistles that Triumph can offer on its entry-level motorcycle, for those people, I think the Speed 400 will make absolutely great amount of sense. But for other people, I don't think so. This is a bad option. This is an option that will give you entry into the Triumph segment, the Triumph brand, and introduce you to what a premium category brand has to offer. And moreover, for anyone who wants a motorcycle that is slightly more laid back than the Speed 400, has a good amount of torque right from the word go, and feels very, very similar to a certain Royal Enfield motorcycle, be it the Hunter or be it the Gorilla. In fact, this one sits right in between both those motorcycles in terms of the power and the performance it offers, but still manages to outshine both those motorcycles in terms of the quality of the equipment and the overall build quality. This machine will appeal to those sort of buyers who want quality at a great price, associating themselves with a great brand like Triumph, and at the same time not compromising on usable performance.
So as you saw, I was riding the T4, which is right here with me, at very comfortable 100, 110, 120 kilometers per hour on the Yamuna Expressway. And trust me, you will get to know, if you ride both these motorcycles back to back, that the T4, the way the torque is tuned in this engine, is very approachable. Like I was saying, 85% of that 36 newton meters of torque comes in at 2500 rpm, which is very near to the idling rpm of this motorcycle. So the moment you start on this motorcycle, you never feel a lack of torque, something that you can feel on the Speed 400. Apart from that, from a top speed standpoint, yes, the 9 bhp of difference will impact the top speed, because the Speed 400 reaches around 150 kmph. This one was struggling to go above 137-138, which is very much in line with what Triumph mentioned in the media briefing. But does that top end really make a difference? It will make a difference if you are a person who is obsessed with top speeds, but this motorcycle is actually not meant for that type of a rider. It's meant for a person who wants to ride in a relatively relaxed manner, but at the same time does not want a slow motorcycle. That's what I feel after riding this machine. Where is this motorcycle placed in the market right now is a very interesting point, because this one at 31 bhp is placed right between the competition, which is the Royal Enfield Hunter on one side, which is around 20 odd bhps, and on the other side the Royal Enfield Gorilla 450, which is around 40 bhp. This motorcycle sits exactly between these two Royal Enfield offerings and makes a case for itself. I was very surprised with the way that it rode, because I was expecting, frankly, this motorcycle to be underpowered and thinking, who the hell will buy this at just a 23,000 rupee, you know, benefit that Triumph is offering. Actually, I think this motorcycle will be bought by a lot of people, and in fact, may just end up outshining the Speed 400 in a price-sensitive market like India. You can do what you want on this motorcycle. Have fun, go on a highway ride, go on a city ride. This machine feels nimble, and the things that have been taken out of the Speed 400, while they are kind of top spec stuff, I feel this motorcycle, the Triumph T4, still makes a compelling case for itself. So that is it, what I had to share about this motorcycle with you guys. I just wanted to ride it, feel it myself first, because like all of you who are watching this video, I also had some doubts about what this motorcycle is. And after riding this, I'm pretty convinced this motorcycle really makes a case for itself. That is it for this video. I will see you in the next one.